The topic is thrombotic lesion in the LAD artery. So I'll just show 2-3 cases and then we can discuss. You know. This is my hospital in Jabalpur. And the case is a young man, 42-year-old Kedar Prasad. And he has came with acute MI, stable. And then the angio shows, complete ostial LAD block. And you see the complete ostial LAD block. And then we actually did not do thrombosuction in the beginning, and we just opened the artery, and it looked simple. We opened it, and then we put a stent, and then you see there's a clot at the, between LM and LAD. So the patient was still stable, so we thought what to do with that. So then we did a thrombosuction, and we tried to do a thrombosuction trying to remove the clot. Again, we dilated the that area to try to sort of pinch that clot, but still remains. And then we again tried, and it remains there. So what we a patient was stable, we left him, and then we started a 2B3 infusion for 12 hours. And then next day we take a picture and see he was absolutely fine and there was no need of doing anything more. And there's another very interesting patient who's in my hospital, and he's again a young patient, came with acute MI and stable, but he was thrombolyzed somewhere, and then the vessel didn't open up, and see this is completely ostial LAD block. And then again, actually, we did not do, thrombosuction. We just pre-dilated and thought we'll put a stent. And then see, there's so much of clot from the, it's almost closed. So we then decided to do thrombosuction. Then we did thrombosuction. And then we thought we'll put a stent. And then we put a stent. Okay, but then see what happens. Now there is a big clot at the tri-junction, okay. See, this is a huge clot here, and then some clot went into the LAD, into the diagonal here, okay. But the patient's still stable, and really we thought what to do, should we do more thrombosuction and try to do something, but again, patient is stable. So again, we put him on a 24 hours apsiximab infusion. And again, see, it was very good. And then there's another patient which also did well, but it was a very, very serious patient, Vishal. He came with cardiogenic shock. Okay, so this is on my hospital. So, he came with a cardiogenic shock and completely, left main block, and we didn't know nothing in BP 150. See, young patient. So we thought, let's, do something. The vial went easily. So we thought we'll do thrombosuction, and we did thrombosuction, and the vessel opened. And then we did a stenting, and we keep a IABP ready because BP was low. But as soon as we did all the stent, and we didn't put the IABP first because as soon as we took him to cath lab, BP came around 80-90. So we thought we'll just go like that, and then you see this is the final result. And he did well. There was no need of, we observed him for 12 hours, and there was no need of IABP. And he also did very well. So these are the, our LAD. But there was a very good, RCA patient also, I thought I'll show. It was very difficult because anomalous artery and then RCA. Okay, so he was around 50, and then acute anti-wall MI. And torture. It was very difficult. It took a lot of time to engage because it was an anomalous artery, and we completely 100 grade 4 thrombus, and then we again did a lot of thrombosuction 2-3 times, and he became better, and then we put a stent. So he also did well. Okay, so all these patients did well, and I feel there's still some role for You know, thrombosuction, and we gave 2B3A to all these patients. You know, the present 2017 AC guidelines that the routine thrombosuction should not be given. You know, it's come into the level of recommendation 3. So maybe, but then I think there is some role of thrombosuction, particularly in cardiogenic shock, and it has come down from 1A to I think the 2B recommendation. But there is some role, and I don't know what do you think.